Are y'all ready? Let's do this. Okay. August 31st, 1989 was the day that I was born. So if you doctors came in and rushed me out the room. I was born with a congenital birth defect, fibula hemimelia. So my legs didn't develop in the womb. My mother and father didn't know, and they rushed me out the room and took me to ICU. And the doctors had to come back and have this conversation with my mother and father. Mr. and Mrs. Leeper, I'm sorry, but your baby boy Blake was born missing both of his legs. And the doctors are coming in saying that he's never gonna walk a day in his life. Why me? Why do I have to go through this? Why do I have to face this? I remember a time when I was about 5 years old, 4 or 5 years old, and I was playing baseball. And I wanted to do one thing, and that was to hit a home run. Right. So I remember like it was yesterday, I walk up to the plate and I take my 3 practice swings, right? 1, 2, and on the 3rd one, I hit the ball as far as I can, the ball starts flying. I get so excited, I forget to run, right? I'm just like, and my teammates are like, run, Blake, run, run. So I'm on my way to first base, right? And on my way to first to second, I look over to my teammates and they're cheering for me. They're yelling, and this is it. This is the moment. I look over to my father on third base and he's jumping up and down. He's screaming like, oh my goodness, this is it. But from second base to third base, my leg falls off. Boop. Ah. The kid comes over and tags me out. I remember looking over at my teammates and all that excitement was gone. I can remember looking at my father, and he was disappointed, not at me, but at the situation, right? I remember being mad at the world. I remember being mad at the situation. I remember questioning, like, no, this isn't fair. What did I do to deserve this? All my teammates, they have their legs. My mother, she has her legs. My brother, he's fine. Why me? Why do I have to go through this? Why do I have to face this? This, all I wanted to do was to make my father proud. And you mean to tell me I can't even do that? Why me? I don't deserve this. I don't get this. And in that moment, the fact that my leg fell off and I let my father down and I let my teammates down, it was nobody's fault. The reality of it is, it's life. But guess what? It was my responsibility to get back up. It's my responsibility to figure this out. It's my responsibility to say, okay, Blake, you failed this time. I was asking the wrong question. I was losing my power trying to blame things, blame life, blame the situation. I realized in this life, you have 2 choices. It's either fault or responsibility. That's it. They don't go together. In that moment, when I failed in that moment, I was looking for fault. It's life's fault. It's her fault. It's his fault. It's their fault. I don't deserve this. But I decided to flip it. I decided to take control over my life. Instead of asking why me, ask myself, well, why not me? I'm meant for this. Why not me? I'm strong enough for this. Why not me? I'm smart enough for this. I'm a true believer that everything that we go through in our lives is for a reason. And whether it's something small or something big, what we're facing today is preparing us for tomorrow. My mom always told me every morning that I woke up, she said, Blake, yes, you have 2 disabilities. Yes, but you have 1,000 other abilities that makes you a special person. You have 1,000 other abilities that allows you to wake up each and every day, put a smile in your face, and go and attack the world. I used to say life is 10% of what you're dealt with and 90% on how you deal with it. You look at my life and you look at my situation, the fact that I was born without legs, that's my 10%. There's nothing I can do about it. There's nothing that I could do about it. This is who I am. This is my life, right? But I still have 90% to show the world what I truly can do. I still have 90% to wake up each and every day and with the opportunity to fight, to keep pushing through. This is not my determination. This does not define me. I choose to accept my 10% and take the 90 and go and attack the world. I take my 90 and every day that I wake up, I say I'm gonna walk. Every day that I wake up, I say I'm gonna run. Every day that I wake up, I say I'm gonna be the fastest man in the world, point blank period.